Hello everyone, I am Dr. Arun Sharma. In this video, we will talk about matter and its classification. What is matter? Matter is any substance which has mass and occupies some space, that is called matter. Examples of matter are like iron, gold, plastics, cloths, wood, air, water, milk, kerosene oil, etc. So we can say that any material which have some mass and it occupies some space in the atmosphere or in environment, so that type of substance is called matter. We can classify matter into two major components or two major parts. First is physical classification or the physical component, and second one is the chemical classification or chemical component. Now, physical classification can further classify it into three categories: solids, liquids and gaseous. But chemical classification, as if we consider the chemical classification, it is divided into two parts: pure substances and mixtures. Pure substances are further divided into two categories. First is elements and second one is compounds. Both elements and compounds are homogeneous. Compounds can further classified into inorganic compounds and organic compounds. Now we come to the mixtures. Mixtures were further classified into homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixtures. These are solutions, homogeneous solutions or heterogeneous solutions. Now in detail, we will discuss about the physical classification of matter. Physical classification is based on the physical state of the matter, which is exist under the ordinary conditions of temperature and pressure. Matter can be classified into three types as per physical conditions: solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. Here the images of the solid, liquid and gaseous are shown in this video. In case of solids, you can see that the particles are tightly packed and cannot be moved freely. But in case of liquids, particles are loosely packed and there will be some observable distance between the particles, and particles can move freely. In case of gases, here the image shown, particles are very far away from each other, so the particles are loosely packed and in a continuous random motion. Now come to the chemical classification of matter. Based on the chemical state under the ordinary conditions of temperature and pressure, the chemical classification has been done, and mainly chemically two types of matter can be classified. First is the pure substances and second was the mixture. Pure substances is a material that contains only one type of substance, that is called a pure substance. So in case of pure substance, there will be no any type of impurity. And pure substances are further classified into two types. These are called elements and compounds. Now what is element? An element is defined as a pure substance that contain only one type of atoms. Like here we have some examples. In pure gold, 24 karat gold, there will be no impurity. Only aurum elements, atoms are present in the gold. In case of carbon, so any type of carbon nanomaterial like carbon quantum dots, carbon nanotubes, only the carbon atoms are present, no impurity were found. In case of sulfur, like there are so many allotropes of sulfur, rhombic sulfur, monoclinic sulfur. So in case of there will be only pure sulfur atoms. In case of oxygen, there will be pure oxygen atoms having the atomic number of the oxygen, we know that is 8. In case of iron, the atomic number is 26, and in case of pure iron, there will be the pure 100% iron elements atoms are there. Since 216, the periodic table has 118 confirmed elements from element 1, atomic number 1, that is hydrogen, and to 118 atomic number, that is oxygen. Now come to the compounds. Compounds consisting of one and only one type of molecules are called pure compounds. For example, water. Water is a pure compound because it consists only of water molecules or H2O molecules, because we know the formula of water is H2O. So there will be no impurity, no any type of hardness. If we do not consider any hardness, so there will be the pure H2O molecules in the water. But in case of gasoline is also a liquid, but it is not a pure compound because it is a mixture of various hydrocarbons. Petroleum ether, diesel, kerosene, paraffin wax. So these are the petroleum ether. So these are the various hydrocarbon mixture of hydrocarbons. Gasoline is the mixture of hydrocarbons. So that is not a pure compound. But water is a pure compound. Mainly compounds are classified into two types. First is inorganic compounds and second one is organic compounds. What are inorganic compounds? As we know that about inorganic chemistry. In inorganic chemistry, we studied about the inorganic compounds. An inorganic compound can be considered as a compound that does not contain a carbon-hydrogen bond. In inorganic chemistry, we are not studying that compound having the carbon and hydrogen, presenting carbon and hydrogen and the bond between them. So, in case of inorganic compounds, we only study about the inorganic materials like sodium chloride, magnesium chloride, aluminium chloride. So these are the inorganic compounds, or we can say that these are the ionic compounds, or the mixture of two compounds, like sodium is the cationic part and chloride is the anionic part. In magnesium also cation and chloride is anion. So these are the combination of cation and anion, we get the inorganic compounds. But in case of organic compounds, in organic compounds, the carbon hydrogen bond is to be considered, and because in most of the organic compounds generally we found the carbon hydrogen bond. Maybe there will be the saturated or unsaturated. If the compound is saturated, that means there will be the single bond, and if the unsaturation is found, then there will be the double bond or triple bond. So in case of the benzene, there will be the double bond is there. In case of acetylene, there will be the triple bond. Few organic compounds do not contain carbon hydrogen. There will be some exceptions also, like in case of carbon tetrachloride and urea. We know the formula of urea, NH2CONH2, aminomethanamide. That is the IUPAC name of urea. So we found that there will be no carbon hydrogen bond in case of carbon tetrachloride and urea. Now we come to the mixtures. Mixture, what is mixture? Mixture contains particles of two or more pure substances which may be present in it in any ratio. Like there are two types of mixtures, homogeneous mixtures or heterogeneous mixtures. In detailed study of mixtures will come over next video. So keep it watching, and for the generating of interest in the video lectures, I am putting here some interesting top points that will be the important part of your competitive examinations. So here I am putting the who is the first Nobel Prize winner in chemistry. As you all know that in 1901, Van't Hoff, in my previous video I have discussed that he was the Dutch chemist who got the first Nobel Prize in chemistry for his discovery of the laws of chemical dynamics and osmotic pressure in solutions. That was Van't Hoff. Van't Hoff first awarded Nobel Prize in chemistry. Please be remember, it is very important because it may generally asked in various examinations. So Van't Hoff is the Dutch chemist who got the first Nobel Prize in 1901. Please like and share my video and also subscribe my channel. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me. My contact details are given in this video. So your studies be continue and go through these video lectures and ask any problems and doubts if you have. Thank you.